But we encourage that you do it. But you bought it, so you can get, you can say, I want my own.
Of today's Tribute Store Tour. I originally was going to do an extremely long, in-depth review of this Tribute Store because I initially did have quite a few gripes, mostly in the fact that there's not a lot of power shots in the Tribute Store comparatively to the HHN Tribute Store, but then I realized it's really only the Harry Potter room that I have a lot of gripes with. I do think that they pepper Christmas trees a little too much. Like, here we have some dead space. Let's just throw a Christmas tree in and it'll be fine. But really, the only room that really, really does that is the Harry Potter room. I think that the Harry Potter room is kind of bland comparatively to, like, say, the Grinch room and the Earl the Squirrel Christmas Tree Farm room, which is my favorite room. Because it's just got this whole awesome story going on, all of this food. And it really characterizes Earl the Squirrel, which is, you know, always fun to see an original theme park character get that much love. Kind of like Figment. You know what I mean? That's how I kind of feel Earl the Squirrel has been portrayed this year in the Tribute Store. And it's fantastic. The first room of the Tribute Store, which is the kind of traditional German village type thing with nutcrackers and such, and then just generalized Universal Christmas merchandise, is fine. I don't have too many problems with it. It doesn't really affect me in any way. It's just kind of eh, in my opinion. It's eh, which is, there's nothing wrong with that. Some people like it. I personally just don't really have any strong emotional connections to it, unlike other rooms. So it's just, it's fine. You know what I mean? It's fine. But the Grinch room, love it. So much fun. So much color. There's a lot of great details in it, like the fireplace that's got the kind of Whovian architecture, and then the doorway going into the hallway, which also kind of has that Whovian architecture, and then the really great set piece with the Grinch and all of the toys. So it's quite fantastic, in my opinion. I really like that room. Then you go into the hallway, which kind of looks like they just put more fences where the HHN posters were, and they were just like, we don't want to have to, like, redo that next year, so we're just going to put some fences and put the holiday posters over it. And I don't know if that's how it is. I'd have to go back and look at my HHN Tribute Store footage to see if they really just put fences up. That way they can just keep what they had already done. And if they did, that's very funny, in my opinion. Then you go into the Harry Potter section, which I already mentioned. Kind of bland. There are no power shots in it. It's just kind of some shelves with Christmas and generalized Harry Potter merchandise on it, which, you know, it's nice, but I can just go to Diagon Alley where they actually have really great Harry Potter stores selling the same merchandise and, you know, probably not have to wait in a line to get in. Sorry. But that's just how I feel about that room. And then the final room, of course, Earl the Squirrel, and all of the treats and such are in that room, and each one with their own sign. It's fantastic. I really like it. And then you go into the last hallway until you get to the exit, and the exit has like a great little display with like the Come Back Soon thing, and he's driven his truck through it. It looks very cute, very fun, really great room. So the tribute store for the holidays, it's a good first time doing it. And I really like the facade as well with the ginormous nutcracker. It looks really cool. And the first like area where you enter has a lot of really awesome details that I wasn't really able to capture, and I'll try to capture them better the next time that we go. But it's got like a Harry Potter, it's got Hogwarts Castle, it's got the lighthouse, it's got the volcano from Volcano Bay, and then it's got the arches. So it's got a lot of great details that are noticeable when you are looking for them, but if you aren't looking for them, you're not really gonna see them. But it's good to have tiny details like that. They really enhance the experience, personally, I think. So it's a good first tribute store. I was gonna compare it to like this year's HHN tribute store, but I don't think that's fair because they've been doing the HHN tribute store for a while now, whereas this is their first crack at a holiday tribute store. So saying comparatively it's not good would be very rude, in my opinion. So gets a thumbs up if you're at Universal. Do not miss it, along with the Macy's Christmas balloon walkthrough thing. That is even more fantastic than the tribute store. So those are two holiday experiences at Universal that you most definitely do not want to miss. And another thing, I was finally able to get this, and I might review them. I don't know. Who knows? They're great. I think they're very good. This set, I was originally a little skeptical of whether I was gonna like it or not, but I like it. It's fun. The build, it's nice. And the 501st Battle Pack is fantastic. Maybe I'll review them, maybe I won't. We'll see. But until then, as always, be positive.